Here's a question. How did we go from room-sized calculators to attempting to recreate human intelligence in ones and zeros? Let's rewind. IBM creates the first accounting machine. Punch card in, account balance out. That's called data processing. The 1930s roll around and Alan Turing invents the concept of programming by breaking a big problem into smaller problems, all the way until each one is a bite-sized yes or no. A decade later, Konrad Zuse takes this concept and makes the first truly programmable digital computer. Now, people can flick some switches on a circuit and make their very own program. And calculate things. 1954. IBM decides we're done with switches. Let's program in human language. And they do. Fortran is created. Now we can program with human words. And the ideas kept coming. The first language which managed to encapsulate the idea of a thing was created, Simular. Now, we can define an object digitally, letting programmers mimic real-life systems. Shortly after, SQL, the language for optimizing large amounts of data, was written. Feel free to insert, search, manipulate, and delete data within your databases. It's like someone finally invented an index for a book. And then, boom, the personal computer is born. Now, even 12-year-old Jimmy can own a computing machine in his bedroom, and he can just move windows around his screen instead of flipping switches on a circuit. Soon enough, all the computers are connected through the magic of internet. Now, Jenny can search the web for information about software development, and using the super simple language of HTML, even create her own websites. Then, a group of software gurus wrote what's known as the Manifesto for Agile Software Development. In just 68 words, the development process was changed forever, with methods such as Scrum and Kanban. Some years later, and machine learning finally takes off. Programs that can teach themselves to recognize patterns, create strategy, and reach their own conclusions through trial and error. Remind you of anyone? This all happened in only 100 years. Where will we be 100 years from now?